at himself.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Let's send it down to Mike Schmitz, who's on the floor.
We're here with James Bouknight out of UConn, one of the most explosive scorers in the entire draft. James, how's Chicago been treating you so far?
Man, it's good, man. The whole process has just been exciting. I'm happy to be here.
So what is an NBA team getting in James Bouknight?
I think they're getting someone you know who you can get the ball to and ask him to go get a bucket. But I honestly feel like I'm more than that type of player. I feel like I rebound at a high level for my size and the position I play, but I also compete on the defensive end of the ball.
So if I would have told you, you know, 5 years ago, 4 years ago, that you'd be sitting at the NBA Combine right now as a projected lottery pick, what would you have said?
Yeah, man, I would have laughed at you. I'm kind of like a late bloomer, so I didn't start playing basketball really seriously until like my freshman year in high school. So this really is like a dream come true.
Yeah, what do you remember about that decision? Because I remember you were sitting down at a table with your mom, and you had Siena as an option, yeah, and then prep school as an option. Uh-huh. What do you take us through that?
At the time, I didn't have this vision. Like, I didn't see me playing, being in this position and being here today. So it was really a decision that came down, and ultimately choosing McDuffie was the right route.
And then you end up at UConn, and you show off your explosive scoring ability, like I said. We're going to break down your game, but before we get into that, I'm just curious, who are some of the players that you've been watching and you take little things from as you make the leap to the NBA?
A lot of people like to make the comparison about the Devin Booker comparison, the Bradley Beal comparisons, but I really try not to compare myself to anybody. Being a late bloomer, I just feel like my game is just creative and unique in its own different type of way.
Yeah, no question. And your ability to create space off the bounce, you can score it at all three levels. We're going to break down just what makes you such a dynamic scorer in the half court. And I think so much of it is your handle and your ability to create space, get to these step backs. Take me through this move here.
Yeah, so it's just me and my defender just one-on-one, and being a New York guard, you got to be able to get a bucket in a one-on-one situation, and that's what I did there.
Yeah, you got the New York game, no question about it, and then now they got to respect the jumper so you can play off that hesitation, right?
Yeah, I got the switch on a big man, and that's the switch we wanted, and just having a quick first step getting by my defender and just finishing out the rim.
And I love how you extend around the rim as well. I think you're a really underrated finisher, really explosive at the rim as well, and you can also play out of these quick actions too. You're a guy who can score off of handoffs. What are you looking at here?
Yeah, this whole pre-draft process, I've been working on my floater and like playing in that mid-range area, and that's just a big part of it.
Yep, and then reading the defense here with the back cut, I think that's going to be huge. Like, how can you generate offense without needing that many dribbles, right? So the next step is making these pick and roll reads, right? So maybe it's slow down, get into his body. You can, you know, let your roller roll, and that's going to suck in the defense. Maybe hit the weak side. There you have the strong side corner on the kick. How have you evolved as a facilitator, and what are you studying to kind of make that next jump as a playmaker?
I feel like just because the role I was in at UConn, being that guy that needed to get buckets and to help the team win, I feel like just going to somewhere where I can showcase my playmaking ability, that's going to be essential for my growth as a player.
Yeah, no question, and that's what we've seen from guys like Devin Booker or even a Jamal Murray type Bradley Beal. You know, they've evolved as facilitators, and I think you have the ability to do the same.
Yes, sir.
Yo, James, this is Jay Billis. First of all, I love watching you play, but in assessing your game, you are so good at creating shots, shooting off the dribble. One of the things that in watching you that I thought, well, you can really improve there are two things. Your three-point shooting, and then your shooting in catch-and-shoot situations.
Yeah.
Is that something? Do you think I'm wrong there? And what are you doing to work on those things, if you think I'm right?
No, I agree with you. This whole pre-draft process, I've been down in Miami working out with Ronnie Taylor, and that's been a big point of emphasis. Just getting up a ton of reps, three-point shots all over the court, and just being ready. Staying ready, and it's just a lot of getting reps in.
And James, LaFonso Ellis here. Regarding your three ball, is it more mechanics in terms of how you catch and release? Is it more legs? What is it that you've been working on specifically?
Like I said, it's just reps. I feel like the mechanics are there, and I feel like it's just going to come together with reps.
James, John Schriffen on the desk. I'm always interested to hear the questions the players get asked by executives. Was there one question you got asked that really caught you off guard?
There were a few that caught me off guard. I don't remember exactly, but I was stunned by a couple. But all my meetings been going well, and I'm excited for this whole thing. I'm excited to be here, and I'm really blessed.
Well, we appreciate you spending some time with us. Good luck in the upcoming draft.
Thank you, guys.
James Bouknight, star out of UConn.